CBS 13's Macy Jenkins is live in West Sacramento tonight getting answers on how the state is making sure there is enough energy to go around. Macy.
Well, Adrian and Sam, managers of the state power grid say they've been watching these temperatures since Friday, but back-to-back days of triple-digit numbers make it challenging to keep all of the grid up and running.
A difference in 1 or 2 degrees can mean a difference in how many megawatts that we have to supply to utilities.
The California Independent Systems Operator, ISO for short, controls California's power grid. And spokesperson Ann Gonzalez says they've been keeping an eye on the forecast.
This is where all of that planning comes into play.
They've told electric companies to reduce strain on the power grid by not shutting down power plants for maintenance.
We need you to be online and ready.
Tuesday is expected to see the highest amount of energy used in California in 10 years.
Does it surprise you?
Not for a 5-day heat wave.
So will there be enough power to go around? Between the high Sierra snow melt creating more hydropower and record solar power generation, Gonzalez says yes.
June, July, and August are very sunny months, and lots of solar energy can be produced.
Still, high temps mean high stress on power lines.
There was kind of a pop, and then everything went quiet and went dark and got hot.
About 200 homes in this Arden neighborhood lost power for nearly 2 hours after a fuse blew overhead.
Keep down and keep cool and not move around more than we needed to.
CAISO just issued a flex alert for the next 2 days, asking Californians to conserve electricity during the late afternoon when air conditioners are typically at peak use.
They're very, very helpful, and we appreciate when the public responds.
But cutting back on the AC isn't ideal for people like Tom Grant, who plan to be home during the hottest time of the day.
I hope this isn't the beginning of a long week for all of us, but it could be.
Now, the flex alert is in place for Tuesday and Wednesday between 2 and 9 p.m. They're asking people to not use unnecessary lighting in the home. Make sure that your AC is at 78 degrees or higher. And make sure if you're running a pool pump, run it at night instead of during the day.
All right. Some important advice there. Macy Jenkins reporting live for us tonight. Thanks. Cooling centers are also opening up all around our area. For locations and hours, you can visit our website, cbs13.com.